Alright boys, in this video I'm going to be breaking down how you can make one YouTube video, use a WhatsApp group to get one client already signed on, one pending, and five sales calls in the span of 24 hours. How can I say that I can guarantee you such results? I obviously can't guarantee you such results, but I'm fairly confident since I've actually done this myself. Okay, I uploaded this video, I made this WhatsApp group, and within the span of 24 hours, now it's actually more calls booked, but within just the first 24 hours of me creating the group, I booked five calls, as you can see, one, two, three, four, five. All have been taken, I think. There have been no-shows. There's been one close, one pending, all super warm calls, all super qualified, and there are more on the way. In this video, I want to be showing you how you can get similar results. Okay, in the first 24 hours, I got 13 joins into the group. I booked five calls. Three were taken at the time of scripting this video. Now one more has actually been taken. One person has been closed, and one person is pending. Okay, in this video, I want to break down the key principles to help you do the exact same thing. Okay, first insight, kind of like. I just wanted to mention this because I think it's relevant. I think I know how Iman feels like now. I literally made one call to action and I got free calls plus clients. Once again, completely free calls plus clients. It's one thing to run an ad and get clients, right? But I actually got free calls plus clients just from the audience that I've built for like 5 minutes of work. I think this is an actual glitch in the matrix. And I think if you're not leveraging this, which I want to show you, which like hint, it's YouTube. I do not know what you're doing. Why do I believe I can do this? I think it's because I have trust with an audience. And in fact, I'm 100% sure it's because I have trust with an audience. Okay, I've spent a lot of time building up my audience on YouTube. And guess what? Now I've just reached a point to where I have so much trust built up with that audience. And I have the leverage to make good freaking videos that I can just call to action. And I have calls flowing to me and I have clients flowing to me. Okay, and the key point here is that I have actual trust, okay, which I believe is the most valuable currency in the online game that we're all playing. Okay, people will talk about trust and then they'll tell you to post Instagram reels and saying that you will build trust that way. Complete bullshit, not enough in 2024. Okay, it's not enough time, right? 7 hour rule, which I think has actually been extended to the 14 or 21 hour rule, right? Which states that you need at least 7 hours of interaction between you and the prospect, where it's on camera, whatever it is, they need to consume 7 hours of your content before they become your hottest lead, before they're ready to buy, right? 7 hours using short form, good freaking luck, right? Two is not enough depth. How can you go deep into a concept like I'm going here? With a short form video, you just can't, right? A lot of it is just regurgitating information and it's very surface level stuff. And it's not enough you, right? Any beginner can memorize a script, they can speak for 30 seconds, but me presenting this entire document, going off the cuff sometimes, is going to build way more trust and way more likability and way more of a connection between you and me than if I were to just record a 30 second short that was scripted anyways. Okay. Have you ever bought a high ticket program from someone just because they posted IG reels and that was enough? Because I personally know I never have. Everyone I've bought programs from, I've bought courses from, I've bought mentorships from or whatever, it's always been because they have a YouTube channel and I found out about them usually through that YouTube channel. They never called DM'd me, I naturally got to like them and I ended up buying their stuff because I liked it. That is always the process. Okay, and if it's a process with you and how you buy stuff, how can you expect your clients and your prospects to think differently when they're making their buying decisions? You can't, right? And a lot of them are going to make it through watching YouTube videos, building a connection, and then buying from that person. Right, which is why I'm preaching YouTube so freaking much, because it's naturally how we make our buying decisions and it's naturally how you actually get clients in this online game moving forward, right? For example, right, Iman, like, is Iman posting reels? Some, right, but he's actually pretty old and they're not nurturing reels, they're lifestyle reels, right, which he posts just to keep up his lifestyle on Instagram, right? Well, guess what? He's still posting videos on YouTube, right? If you look at guys like Nick Cosman, his Instagram actually got banned, but even before it was banned, he was not posting any Instagram reels, because why the hell would he? He was just using stories to monetize at one point, right? However, he's not posting on Instagram. He never was going ham on Instagram, but he's always been on YouTube. Right now, he's taking a break, right? 30-day social media hiatus. However, it's because he's focused on his business. Once this is done, he's going to go back to posting YouTube videos, because he was posting very freaking often. He was live streaming very freaking often. Why? Because this works. Right, and then lastly, guys like Joel Kaplan, right? He used to be super, super heavy on reels. Recently, he's actually slowed down. He's stopped all of his fancy editing. He's just done a few Q&As, and he's not doing them as often as used to. Right, but guess what? If you look at his YouTube, he's still posting on his YouTube channel. Right, a very clear and common trend that people aren't noticing that I want you to notice. Okay, short form content is dead unless you're selling short form content. Right, you should not be making short form content, in my opinion. It's a waste of time, and you can allocate that same attention that you spent scripting out short form, you know, recording the short form, editing the short form if you're editing yourself, or even paying the editor, you can allocate that same amount of time and attention to making a freaking banger long form video that's going to do well, and that's going to get you more goodwill with the marketplace, ultimately more calls and more clients down the line, than if you were to spend that same time doing shorts. Makes no freaking sense. Long form, way more leverage. It's a way better way to spend your time, in my opinion. Okay, which is why I'm I've doubled my or tripled my long form content posting frequency, but I've completely stopped shorts. Right, with shorts, one of the main problems is that you're performing non-evergreen actions. Okay, I've spoken about this before, but the main thing is you're performing actions that have no visible impact on how your business is going to do in the future, right? Because shorts, they get views for like 2 days, then they get cut off and they're done. And guess what? You have to post more shorts, and you trap yourself in this flywheel of making some short-term money, right? But then you have to go back to performing these non-evergreen actions, and guess what? Freedom is gone and it's non-existent, right? Work, 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 and you just keep working. And not only that, when you make IG reels, because of the way this market's operating, like you've probably never bought anything high ticket off of someone because you watched a short. 99.9% short, you've never done that because you've never seen it happen. Okay, you make IG reels, so you attract shitty clients because the best clients do not look for their future partners. I've always said cold DMs, but also on shorts, like, do you like watch shorts, scroll shorts? Oh, this guy can help me scale my business. Of course not, you go to YouTube for that place, right? So we attract shitty clients because those are the ones scrolling Instagram. The real business owners that you want to work with, they're not scrolling Instagram. I deleted Instagram because why the hell would I have Instagram, right? All the good clients, they're not on Instagram. So we attract shitty clients with no emotional investment. Once again, you lower your prices, same with cold DMs. You get shitty results, same with cold DMs. And you end up with no case studies, no cash flow, no financial stability for the future because you have to go back to performing non-evergreen actions. You have no time, you have no freedom, and you're burnt out. Another thing that I want to touch on is why school and why not WhatsApp? Because this video, in the end, I mean, I'm talking about content. Why content? Right, and I think I've explained that part, but why the hell WhatsApp? Because a lot of you might think, like, that's really interesting. Why not school? Everybody's going ham on school right now. I'm gonna explain that in this video because I've been talking about WhatsApp, but I haven't explained why I actually use it over school. So that's what I want to do. Okay, school is amazing, right? But it's a great education platform. You can host courses on there, you can have an actual community that interacts with each other, right? That's cool, but that's not really our goal, right? Our goal is to have a personal connection with our audience, because ultimately that's what's going to allow us to monetize most. Our goal with this community is giving value, personal connection, and monetization on the back end, right? School is inferior to WhatsApp, in my opinion, from what I've tested, from what I've tried, from what I've heard. And a huge reason for that is because what we want to do with this is, since we're using YouTube to get all of our clients, is we want to compensate for the one thing that YouTube doesn't have, which is one-to-one DMing. Instagram is amazing because you can DM one-on-one, right? That's the perk that it has. YouTube does not have that perk. So we got to, in some way, compensate for it. Right, we got to get that personal connection with an audience, because you're watching these videos, you're getting nurtured, okay, cool, amazing. However, I do not have a touch point with you where I can speak to you one-on-one, right, and actually connect with you on a deeper level, right, on a personal level. Because this video is obviously evergreen, I'm not speaking directly to you, although it may seem that way, and although I'm trying to make it seem that way. So WhatsApp basically removes the only constraint that YouTube has, okay, and I mean, usually people use Instagram for these sort of purposes, but I do not like it, many reasons, right? First of all, not everyone has WhatsApp, or has Instagram, right? Very simple reasoning. Okay, people's DMs are flooded, right? The moment you send someone a DM, right, because, you know, they follow you on Instagram, or they even DM you on Instagram, like, you're putting yourself in the same bucket as all these people that are cold DMing these same leads. You're positioning yourself once again as low status. Not fun. We want to be in a different bucket. That different bucket is WhatsApp for me. And there's no way to create a solid community, because ultimately you're inviting people to a community. You're inviting them for value. The moment you tell them to DM you for free resources, it's kind of salesy, because you know they're going to be appointment set. Not really fun, right? So I prefer WhatsApp, which you can actually create a community, right? Plus, plus, all of this leads to a lower conversion rate on Instagram, okay, from everything that I've seen, right? WhatsApp, like, what's this? Out of 10 real leads, because I had 13 joins, three of which were my friends, 5 calls, 50% conversion rate on the initial joins. Insane. If you think you're getting that from Instagram, you're not getting that from Instagram, okay? So another reason to use WhatsApp. And then finally, every time I open IG, I scroll. Every single freaking time, which is why I've also deleted it, right? It's just, like, from like a broader business perspective, it's not a good play, right? So what my thought process is I uninstalled Instagram, I have less distractions, I pump out more YouTube videos, and I make more money, right? That's the flywheel that I've sort of put in motion here, okay? And then also in relation to school, once again, right, no one uses the school app on your phone, right? I literally haven't come across anyone who actually has it, who actively uses it, which means that you're going to be speaking to people who are on their desktop, and they open school up maybe once or twice a day, right? So convos are long, they take days, and they're dead, right? And a reason for why they're dead is because there's no voice notes, right? On school, you cannot send a voice note, you have to type everything out, whereas if you go over here on WhatsApp, you can send voice notes. I do send voice notes, and I mean, here's an example, bro. You actually can't see this here, but this dude sent me like 5 minutes worth of voice notes, right? Amazing. I got all the info I need. I built a human connection with him. That's exactly the point. On school, you think he's going to type for 15 minutes? Of course not. This just makes it so much easier and so more personal, which is why I prefer it over school. Okay. So that is, I think, all I wanted to cover in this video. Yes, this is the next video that I want to record next. But yeah, I appreciate you watching. If you're not in the WhatsApp group yet, I want you to join it. There's a lot of free stuff in there. I want to reach out to you, and I want to offer you value, and I want to see if I can help in any sort of way. But overall, you're going to get a lot of freaking value from this community, and I'm super, super active in there too. It's not the type of community where you just join and it's dead. I'm actively dropping value. I'm drip feeding value in there every single week is the sort of cadence that I'm trying to do here. So join up. You're going to get a lot of free stuff that you don't get here on YouTube. And if you're ready for us to help you build your own creator business, to copy email and stop posting short form content, to start actually posting long form content, build your own creator business, build your own audience so that you can monetize the exact same way that I'm doing here and the way that our clients are doing that I've shown in previous videos here, maybe, nope, not in this video, but I've shown the results here. If you want to get similar results, right, you can look at threes. If you like, there's more on my Instagram, you can book in a call and we can have that conversation. We can see what it would be like to build your own creator business. Okay, I appreciate you watching this video. I'll see you guys on the call, if not, in the WhatsApp group. And also in the next video, which is going to be dropping tomorrow. See you guys.